Dogumentary TV, producing the best breed documentaries on YouTube.
Hey, what's going on, guys? This is Zeke. This is Dogumentary TV. This is the YouTube channel for dog lovers. If you guys have not already, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. In addition, if you would, turn on the notification bell and give this video a like if you indeed like the video. I don't know if it's the time of year or if it's just that 2020 has been such a bear on most of us that folks are looking for companions. So guys, here we go. I'm going to give you guys my 10 favorite breeds for first-time dog owners. All right, guys, at number 10, I have the Great Dane. Now, this is a rather large dog breed, and that would probably be the only real issue for a first-time dog owner. Great Dane is a giant, goofy dog. But they're pretty much couch potatoes. They're known to be patient and affable and always enjoying a good cuddle. This is one of the few giant breeds that does very well in apartments. The breed's energy level is medium to low. They do need to walk. They do to get outside and exercise. They have a short and easy coat, easy to take care of. In terms of their intelligence, the breed has average intelligence, but can be trained. Just be prepared to give your Great Dane a few more repetitions, a few more opportunities to learn and comprehend a command. All right, guys, the number 9 dog breed on my list is the English Bulldog. And like most Bulldogs, the English Bulldog can be very stubborn. And that pretty much is the only downside to this, to owning this breed for a first-time dog owner. That and that you may also have to be acutely aware of health issues that may face the breed. English Bulldogs are great for first-time dog owners due to their laid-back attitude and very easygoing nature. Every dog should be exercised. Every dog should get outdoors. But an English Bulldog is a very easy to keep dog, even for couch potatoes. All right, guys, number 8 breed on my list, the Boston Terrier. Boston Terriers are very individualistic. Some dogs within the breed are very clownish and high-spirited, while others are very calm and dignified. A bull and terrier breed, so stubbornness can be expected, but for the most part, the breed is sweet and gentle. For the Boston Terrier, playing games and chasing balls are its two passions. Bree has a very short coat, again, which is very good for grooming. Boston Terriers are extremely sensitive and very in tune and connected to its family's mood. Some Boston Terriers can be a one-person dog with a special affinity toward an elderly person or children, but many Boston Terriers are outgoing and friendly with pretty much everyone. Despite the Boston Terrier's sometimes blustery temperament, the breed is fine with other pets. And although it may show some signs of aggression towards larger dogs, they are seldom truly aggressive. Number 7 on my list is the Whippet. Despite being bred for racing, sighthounds like the Whippet are notorious couch potatoes. These breeds are not very trustworthy off-leash though, but they do make for excellent, loving companions in apartments or small homes. Energy level for the Whippet is medium. Whippets will enjoy a good sprint or two, but the breed is not an endurance athlete at all. The Whippet's coat type is short, very short, which makes for easy grooming. In terms of the breed's intelligence, it's average, but the breed is very much trainable. If you love the look of the dog, I think these are great dogs for first-time dog owners. Really, the only activity that these dogs will obsess over is running. Just be sure to be in a position to get your dog enough wind sprints in a day. Keep them happy. Number 6 on my list is the Basenji. I love the Basenji. These dogs are great family companions. They will adapt well to living in small spaces. The breed's coat is dense, so very light on the grooming. Very intelligent and clever, but still can be trained. But if you want to own a Basenji as a new dog owner, just be prepared to provide the breed with tremendous amounts of exercise. That means a lot of walking, traveling, running, and playtime. And playtime would be activities around the house that will require the dog to think and express his cleverness. If you can manage to keep your Basenji tired, you will find that they're an excellent dog breed for a first-time dog owner. The number 5 dog breed on my list is the French Bulldog. French Bulldogs are a good choice for first-time dog owners. The breed requires less exercise, and because of the breed's short, dense coat, grooming them is a very simple task. The breed is extremely loving and makes for great couch companions. The breed is of average intelligence, but very much food-motivated. So training should not be such a big deal if you use the right incentives when training your French Bulldog. Okay, guys, the number 4 dog on my list is the Greyhound. Another sighthound, And I know some may think that sight hounds, because they love to run and are probably not easily to maintain off leash, are probably not necessarily best for first time dog owners. But if you keep your dog on a leash, they become excellent. So anytime you bring a sight hound into your life, be prepared to walk your dog on a leash. No sight hound breed is great off leash. But the great thing about the greyhound is that it is a very intelligent dog breed, very easily trained, easily groomed. And there's nothing more that a greyhound enjoys than snuggling after a nice brisk run. All right, guys, the number three dog on my list is the poodle. For my list, we're talking about the standard poodle. But if you like smaller dogs, the breed does come in miniature and toy sizes. The great thing about the poodle, highly intelligent. Some would argue the most intelligent of all dog breeds. So that makes them very easy to train. In regards to grooming, you can choose to style your poodle. But even if you don't go for the fancy stylings in your poodle, you're going to always want to brush your poodle to keep the hair from matting. Aside from the time spent grooming your poodle, you're going to also need to exercise. This breed is very high energy and will need at least 2 to 3 walks a day to maintain a calm state when in the house. But if you have the time and the energy yourself, owning a poodle should not be a problem for a first-time dog owner. The number two breed on my list is the Golden Retriever. There's a reason why the Golden Retriever is a very hugely popular dog all throughout the world. I believe it's the number three most popular dog in the United States, according to the AKC. Breed has a very gentle and playful nature. It is a very uncomplicated breed. Really works off of the drives of being close to its human being and retrieving. Also, the breed is very intelligent, very easily trained. So if you have your heart set on a Golden Retriever being your first dog, I think this is a great breed, a great choice for first-time dog owners. Just be prepared to exercise your dog, keep it tired, and you'll keep your house together because the dog won't be running off the walls. All right, guys, the number one breed on my list is the Labrador Retriever. And this is by far the most popular dog breed in the world, definitely in the United States, according to the AKC. Labradors are a very high-energy dog breed. They will need a lot of exercise. Again, like any retriever, one great way to exercise them is to throw something and have them bring it back to you. So you can do this in a park. You can do this in your backyard. Honestly, you can do it in the house if your house is big enough, because retrievers love to retrieve. Labradors do have a high food drive, so you will see a lot of chunky and chubby Labrador Retrievers out there. That's not necessarily the natural or the best state for the breed. So if you get yourself a Labrador Retriever, be mindful of how much food you're feeding it and make sure that you keep it at a healthy weight. If not, your dog could develop health issues later in life. But like a Golden Retriever, which is very much like a Labrador Retriever, this breed loves to be with its people, loves to retrieve, loves to work, and is very much a very simple dog. If they're with you or if they're working, they're happy. All right, guys, so there you have it, my top 10 dog breeds for first-time dog owners. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. Remember, before you go, subscribe to the channel, turn on notifications, and I will catch you on the next one. Peace. I wonder, is it worth living now? They told me dreams come true once you live it out. I picked up pieces from my childhood in a broken house and healed my soul from the trauma we've been given now. I hear the whispers in the wind under smoky clouds and tell myself once again.